Hey guys, in this episode, I'm going to talk about how you can create your first Blazor WebAssembly application in Windows and Linux. To get started, you're going to need to install .NET SDK version 3.1.3 or greater than that. For IDE, I'm going to use Visual Studio and VS Code, but you can use any IDE that you like. To create our Hello World application, first we'll create through Visual Studio. But if you do not want to install Visual Studio because it takes memory and disk space, you can create your application using Windows command line and use lightweight IDE like VS Code for developing applications. You can also create your application using Linux terminal and use VS Code for developing applications in Linux. So that's something that we're going to talk about too. So let's first talk about how you can create your first application using Visual Studio. If you do not have Visual Studio, you can go to this link. I'm going to post this link in the video description and download community version of Visual Studio because this one is free. Once you install that, then you need to make sure that you have ASP.NET web development workload installed on your Visual Studio. First, you need to make sure that you have the latest version of Visual Studio. I'm using professional version of Visual Studio, but it doesn't really matter. Make sure that you have latest version of Visual Studio. And then you need to make sure that you have ASP.NET and web development workload installed, and you have .NET Core SDK and .NET Core SDK lifetime support individual component installed on your Visual Studio. Once you make sure of that, then you can go to your Visual Studio and create your first application. So I'm going to say that this is a new project, and I'm going to type in here Blazor and select Blazor app template and then click on next. And then I'm going to name my application as Blazing Chat. Select a proper folder. We're going to put it in episode one so that we can keep track of all the episodes. And then I'm gonna click on create. This will give me option to create either Blazor server application or Blazor WebAssembly application. I have already created a series on Blazor server application. You can check the link in the video description, but in this video series, we are going to create Blazor WebAssembly. So I'm gonna select Blazor WebAssembly. I'm not going to select authentication on right side here because for that, I'm going to create a whole another episode discussing about this. But I'm going to select ASP.NET Core Hosted and Progressive Web Application. ASP.NET Core Hosted will give me option to perform all the web API related operations and database related operations, because if I don't select that, then my WebAssembly application is going to be a standalone application. Progressive Web Application, if I select this, then you know it will add the support for making my WebAssembly application as Progressive Web Application so that I can install it on my desktop and use it from there instead of going to the link of the application. So yeah, let's go ahead and create this. So I'm gonna click on create. This will create three projects, and I'm gonna talk about the project structure in the next episode, because this episode will be just creating the application. But here it will create client project, server project, and share project. And let's go ahead and build this and see if we can build it or not. Once this is built, then we'll run it and see how it looks like. Okay, so this is built. I'm gonna click on this IIS Express, which will open up a Chrome window. And it will build the application and it'll push all the DLLs on the browser. So you can see that we are running our first Hello World application on the browser. We'll talk about these pages in this video series, but you know, like I said, we'll be talking about how we can create our application in the series. And if I go to console, you can see that, you know, debugging hotkey and monoasm, git loaded files, all this is, all the good stuff is loaded in our application. Sweet. So this is how you create your first Blazor application. But like I said, if you don't want to install Visual Studio because it's heavy and you know you want to develop an application in VS Code, that's something that we are going to discuss now. For that, I'm gonna go to my Visual Studio and go to the same location because I want to create application there. And then I'm gonna close my Visual Studio because I don't want it to give some errors, and delete this Blazing Chat application that we have created. Okay, so let's assume that I do not have Visual Studio installed on my machine. What I can do, I can go to my command line. I can type in command in that location and open command line here. And I can check if .NET is installed on my machine or not. To check that, what you can do, you can type in .NET and see if, you know, if Windows recognizes your command or not. I have already installed it on my machine, and that's the reason why it's it's showing that it's a valid command. But if you do not have .NET installed on your machine, what you can do, you can just Google .NET, go to .NET, download all .NET versions, go to download .NET Core 3.1 and install .NET from here. If you install the SDK version of .NET, then it includes the runtime for .NET Core, ASP.NET Core, and desktop runtime. So you do not really have to install runtime separately, but yeah, you need to install SDK to get started. I have already installed on it, and that's the reason why you can see this is a valid command. And if you want to check the version of your .NET SDK install, you can type in .NET --- version, and that will tell you the version that you installed, which is installed on your machine. Okay, so let's get started with creating our Blazor WebAssembly application through command line. To do that, what you can do, you can type in .NET new, because we are creating a new application, and type in Blazor WASM, because it's a Blazor WebAssembly application. And then you can tell what is the name of your project. So you can say that output --output, which is going to be Blazing Chat application. But I do want my Blazing Chat application to be a hosted application. So I'm going to say this is a hosted application. And I do want my Blazing Chat application to have the progressive web application support. So I'm going to say progressive web application here. And when I hit enter, this will create this will use the same template that it used for creating application through Visual Studio. So you can see that it created Blazing Chat shared client and server projects, and it created Blazing Chat solution too in the same folder. So if I type in dir, then you can see that it created a Blazing Chat folder here. You can also navigate, you can also go into that directory and say type in .NET build, which will build your Blazor WebAssembly application through command line. And if you want to run your application, what you can do is you can go to your server project, you can go to your server directory and type in .NET run, and that will run your application on 5001, but you do not really have to install any IDE to create your first application. Create, build, and run your first application. So I'm gonna copy this address, go to open my Chrome, and type in that address, and you can see that my Hello World application is just working fine. If I press F12, you can see that all the DLLs are getting loaded in here too. If I refresh this, then the DLLs look in a good format, which you can check it out here. Awesome, right? Okay, so this is how you can, you know, create application and run application through command line, but you do need an IDE to get started, right? You do need an IDE to code into, to develop your application into. And you do not want to install Visual Studio, that's fine, but you can install VS Code, which is super light. And you can go to just Google VS Code, and you can go to this link, which will, you know, you can install VS Code for Windows. you can get the stable build. And after installing, the only thing that you need to do is you can go to your folder where you want to develop your application and just type in code dot and enter. And that will open up your VS Code and see how fast it loaded and how fast it responded to that command. And you can use a VS Code for developing your application, just like, you know, if you're coming from AngularJS or ReactJS background, and if you have habit of using VS Code, you can use VS Code for developing Blazor WebAssembly application too. You do need to install two extensions. One is C#, and other is JavaScript debugging tool. But that's something that we will talk in the next episode. So make sure that you install C# version and JavaScript debugger. Okay, so if you want to run your application through Visual Studio, you can open your terminal using control tilde sign. And here I can type in .NET build, and you can run all the commands that we could run from our Windows command line. And I can say I want to go to server directory and type in .NET run, which will run my application through VS Code so that I can, you know, debug my, you know, check my code here and run application like this. That's pretty cool, right? Okay. So now that we can, you know, create our application through a Windows command line and code through VS Code, let's talk about how we can create our application using Linux terminal and how you can use VS Code for developing applications in Linux. For that, I bought a virtual machine that I'm gonna go to. And this is Linux virtual machine. I have terminal open on it. And I can, to find out if .NET is already installed on this Linux machine, what I can do, I can type in the same command, which is .NET, to find out. I already have .NET installed on it. But if you do not have it, you can go to the same link that we went on for Windows installer. But instead of installing Windows, of course, you'll have to install Linux installer package. And you can click on this link and follow these instructions, the sudo commands to install .NET on your machine, depending on which version of Linux machine that you're using. Okay. And once you do that, then you will have the .NET command. And if you want to check which version of .NET is installed on it, you can type in .NET --version to find out the version which is installed on my machine. We have it 3.1.3, which is the correct version for creating Blazor WebAssembly applications. Okay, so now we can create Blazor WebAssembly application. For that, I'm gonna use the same command, which is .NET new. And I'm gonna type in Blazor WASM because I want to create Blazor WebAssembly application. And then I'm gonna type in, I want this to be hosted. So I'm gonna say --hosted because I want the full stack experience. And I'm gonna say the name of the application is going to be Blazing Chat. And then I want this application to have progressive web application support. So I'm gonna say PWA, sweet. So when I hit enter, this will use the same template that it used for creating application in Windows through Visual Studio and through Windows command line. So let's go to this folder. If I list down here, you can see that it created this Blazing Chat folder. So let's go to that folder. I'm gonna go to Blazing Chat, and then I'm gonna type in .NET build to build this project. And this will build our .NET project that we created on Linux machine. Then I'm gonna go to the server folder to actually run this application. So to do that, I'm gonna say .NET run, and that will run our application on Windows on localhost 5001 port. So if I click on that link, you can see that it opened our Blazor Hello World application on Linux. If I press F12 here, you can see that it loaded all the DLLs in Firefox here. Awesome, right? But yeah, this is how you can create your application. If you want to develop your applications in Linux, you can use VS Code. So you can just Google VS Code here. You can see VS Code, and it will take you to the download link of VS Code, where you can download the Linux version of VS Code to, you know, develop applications, application in VS Code. So I have already installed VS Code on this machine. So the only thing that I need to do is just type in code dot, which will open VS Code in Linux for me, and it will open the same folder that we used for creating our first Blazor WebAssembly application. Like a Windows, like Windows version of VS Code, you'll have to install C# on this, C# extension on this, to have that good experience of, like, to see the compile time error on your editor. You'll have to install that. I have also installed VS Code icons, so that's the reason why I have, like, these nice icons on my project, so that I know, like, which file I'm working on. And just like Windows, we can type Ctrl-tilde to open the terminal, and here also I can type in .NET build to build my application, and I can also go to server and say .NET run to run my first application in Linux on the same port that we ran from command line. Okay, so this is how you can, you know, create and get started with working on Blazor WebAssembly. But the question is, which IDE that we're going to use for the series? I'm going to use VS Code because it's super light, and I feel like it, I understood how .NET really works because I use this lightweight IDE. But you can use any IDE. You can use Visual Studio if you want to, but I'm going to use VS Code because it's super light. That's one reason. And the another reason is because you can use VS Code in the browser. You can enter your GitHub repo and set up an environment in the cloud, and then you can use VS Code in the browser to run and compile your application. And how awesome is that? And you can run your .NET commands here. You can see that .NET commands are working just fine in the browser. That means you don't have to carry your development machine everywhere if you want to change some code. You can just sign in with your Azure account, and you can compile and run your application through the browser. Even if you're using a mobile device, you can, let's say you're using iPad, you can compile your application using iPad. And you can see that it just works fine. That's the reason why I want to use VS Code. I want to get in habit of using VS Code so that I can, you know, carry my environment anywhere that I go. I don't have to carry my laptop for programming in Blazor WebAssembly, or any application that you want to develop in Visual Studio Code. And, but yeah, like I said, if you want to use Visual Studio, you can, but I'm going to use VS Code for the series. So just want to give you a heads up. If you have any questions, you can reach out to me on Twitter or Facebook, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.